Mega hurricanes are approaching. Could a hurricane surpass Category 5? Hurricanes are nature's most ferocious storms, capable of unleashing chaos on an unimaginable scale. But how do we decide how strong a hurricane is? For decades, meteorologists have relied on the Saffir-Simpson Hurricane Wind Scale to categorize these storms. Ranging from Category 1 to Category 5, this scale measures hurricanes based on their sustained wind speeds, with Category 5 being the most extreme, defined as winds as 157 miles per hour or higher. Once a hurricane reaches this threshold, it's classified as a Category 5, regardless of whether winds climb to 170 miles per hour, 200 miles per hour, or beyond. But is this label sufficient? And more importantly, can hurricanes grow so strong that even Category 5 fails to capture their intensity? To answer that, let's first look at how hurricanes are formed and why their strength is capped, or at least used to be. Hurricanes are essentially heat engines fueled by warm ocean waters and favorable atmospheric conditions. They begin as clusters of thunderstorms over tropical waters, where warm sea surfaces heat the air above them. This heat creates upward motion, causing the air to rise and form a low pressure system. As the warm air rises, cooler air rushes in to replace it, and the system begins spinning due to the Earth's rotation. When conditions are just right, low wind shear, high humidity, and ocean temperatures of at least 80 degrees Fahrenheit or 27 degrees Celsius, the system intensifies into a full-blown hurricane. But hurricanes don't grow indefinitely. Factors like wind shear, disruptive winds that tear apart a storm, and dry air intrusion often limit their intensity. Even ocean heat has limits. Once a storm churns through warm waters, it leaves cooler waters in its wake, cutting off its energy supply. These environmental factors have historically acted as natural brakes, capping how strong hurricanes can get. This is where the concept of maximum potential intensity, or MPI, comes in. A theoretical upper limit on how strong a hurricane can become under specific conditions. For decades, MPI calculations suggested that hurricanes couldn't sustain wind speeds much higher than 200 miles per hour, and the Saffir-Simpson scale reflected this understanding. But recent storms have started to challenge that assumption. Hurricanes like Patricia in 2015 and Dorian in 2019 have demonstrated wind speeds that far exceeded the Category 5 threshold, leading scientists to question whether our scale is outdated. Patricia, for example, clocked 215 mile per hour sustained winds, the highest ever recorded in the Western Hemisphere. To put that into perspective, those winds are faster than the takeoff speed of most commercial airplanes. And Patricia isn't alone. Storms like Hurricane Irma 2017, Hurricane Wilma 2005, and Hurricane Mitch 1998 also approached or exceeded wind speeds that would theoretically warrant a new category if one existed. So why does the Saffir-Simpson scale stop at Category 5? When the scale was developed in the 1970s, it was designed as a simple way to communicate risk to the public. At the time, Category 5 was considered a sufficient descriptor for total devastation. Winds of 157 miles per hour or higher were thought to be so destructive that differentiating between, say, 170 miles per hour and 200 miles per hour seemed unnecessary. After all, at those speeds, buildings are obliterated, trees are uprooted, and storm surges overwhelm coastal defenses. But as hurricanes become stronger, this one-size-fits-all approach to Category 5 is being called into question. To understand if hurricanes can surpass Category 5, we need to revisit the driving force behind their intensity – warm ocean waters. Hurricanes derive their energy from the heat stored in the upper layers of the ocean. When sea surface temperatures rise, so does the potential for stronger storms. And here's the alarming part – global ocean temperatures are increasing due to climate change. Over the past century, ocean heat content has been steadily rising, creating a perfect environment for hurricanes to intensify. Today, storms are not only becoming stronger, but also intensifying faster than ever before, a phenomenon scientists call rapid intensification. Rapid intensification occurs when a hurricane's wind speed increases by at least 35 miles per hour in just 24 hours, and it's happening more frequently as the planet warms. For instance, Hurricane Michael in 2018 intensified from a Category 2 to a Category 5 in less than 36 hours before slamming into the Florida Panhandle. Similarly, Hurricane Wilma 2005 went from a tropical storm to a Category 5 in a record-breaking 24 hours. These storms demonstrate that under the right conditions, hurricanes can gain strength at an unprecedented pace, potentially surpassing the limits we once thought unbreakable. Another factor contributing to stronger hurricanes is the reduced temperature difference between the poles and the tropics, a direct result of global warming. This reduced temperature gradient slows down the jet stream, causing hurricanes to linger over warm waters for longer periods. The longer a storm stays over warm water, the more energy it can absorb and the stronger it can become. This phenomenon has led to storms like Hurricane Harvey in 2017, which stalled over Texas and dumped catastrophic amounts of rainfall, and Hurricane Dorian in 2019, which lingered over the Bahamas with sustained winds of 185 miles per hour for more than a day. So can a hurricane surpass Category 5? The evidence suggests that it's not only possible, but that it's already happening. The real question is whether our current classification system is equipped to handle this reality. Some meteorologists have proposed adding a Category 6 to the Saffir-Simpson scale, reserved for storms with sustained winds of 192 miles per hour or higher. Others argue that focusing solely on wind speed oversimplifies the danger of hurricanes, which also includes factors like storm surge, rainfall, and flooding. Regardless of whether we add a new category, one thing is clear: hurricanes are evolving, and so must our understanding of them. Category 5 may have been sufficient in the past, but as ocean temperatures rise and storms grow stronger, the boundaries of what we thought was possible are being redrawn. The question isn't just whether hurricanes can surpass Category 5, it's whether we're prepared to face the consequences when they do. If the idea of a Category 5 hurricane already sounds terrifying, imagine a storm so powerful that even this classification falls short. Could nature create a hurricane capable of rewriting the rule book? To answer this, we need to dig deeper into the cases of recent mega-hurricanes, the growing influence of climate change, and whether the concept of a Category 6 is more than just a hypothetical scenario. To start, let's look at recent hurricanes that have pushed the boundaries of what we thought was possible. Hurricane Patricia was a storm that shocked meteorologists worldwide. With sustained winds of 215 miles per hour, it holds the record for the most powerful hurricane ever recorded in the Western Hemisphere. To put that into perspective, Patricia's winds were strong enough to tear steel-reinforced buildings apart, snap trees like toothpicks, and leave the ground resembling a war zone. Patricia wasn't alone. Hurricanes like Irma in 2017 and Dorian in 2019 also reached catastrophic wind speeds of 185 miles per hour or more, far exceeding the 157 mile per hour threshold of a Category 5 storm. Here's where things get interesting. These storms didn't just graze the edges of Category 5, they obliterated any sense of an upper limit. They raised a critical question. Are we witnessing the emergence of hurricanes that surpass Category 5, or are these just statistical outliers? The answer lies in the role of climate change. As human activity continues to warm the planet, hurricanes are undergoing significant changes. One of the clearest impacts is the rise in sea surface temperatures. Hurricanes thrive on warm water. Think of it as their fuel source. Warmer oceans provide more energy for storms, allowing them to intensify faster and reach higher wind speeds than ever before. Over the past century, global ocean temperatures have risen by about 1.5 degrees Fahrenheit, or 0.8 degrees Celsius, and the rate of warming is accelerating. This might not sound like much, But in hurricane terms, it's like adding rocket fuel to an already dangerous storm. Another climate-driven factor is the increase in rapid intensification events. This phenomenon, where a storm's wind speed jumps dramatically in a short period, has become more common as the planet warms. For example, Hurricane Michael in 2018 went from a Category 2 to a Category 5 in less than 2 days, leaving little time for communities to prepare. Similarly, Hurricane Wilma in 2005 strengthened from a tropical storm to a Category 5 in a single day. These rapid changes make it harder to predict a storm's final strength, increasing the likelihood of hurricanes surpassing our current classifications. And it's not just the oceans that are warming. The atmosphere is changing too. A warmer atmosphere can hold more moisture, leading to heavier rainfall during storms. This means hurricanes are becoming not only stronger but also wetter, dumping record-breaking amounts of rain. Think of Hurricane Harvey in 2017, which stalled over Texas and dumped more than 60 inches of rain in some areas. While Harvey wasn't a Category 5 in terms of wind speed, its rainfall caused catastrophic flooding, showing that a hurricane's destructive power isn't limited to its winds. So can we say a Category 6 hurricane could soon become a reality? Some experts argue that we're already there. Hurricanes like Patricia, with winds far exceeding the Category 5 threshold, highlight the limitations of the current Saffir-Simpson scale. This scale, developed in the 1970s, was never meant to account for the kinds of storms we're seeing today. It was designed as a simple way to communicate hurricane risk, with Category 5 representing total devastation. But storms like Patricia and Dorian have shown that there's a whole new level of devastation that isn't captured by the current scale. What do you think? Should we introduce a Category 6 to better classify these extreme storms? Or is the current system enough to communicate the danger? Let us know your thoughts in the comments below. This idea isn't without controversy. Critics argue that focusing solely on wind speed oversimplifies a hurricane's destructive power. After all, storm surges and rainfall often cause more damage than winds alone. Adding a new category can also confuse the public, making it harder to understand hurricane warnings. But proponents of a Category 6 say it would help highlight the growing threat of these megastorms, especially as climate change continues to raise the stakes. One thing is certain: the hurricanes of the future are not the hurricanes of the past. As the planet warms, the upper limits of hurricane intensity are being pushed further and further. Whether or not we officially recognize a Category 6, it's clear that the boundaries of what we thought was possible are being redrawn. If hurricanes are growing stronger, and Category 5 is no longer enough to describe their power, what does that mean for us and our ability to prepare? The idea of storms surpassing Category 5 isn't just a scientific question. It's a practical one with far-reaching consequences for societies everywhere, especially in vulnerable coastal regions. But before we jump into the future, let's consider the challenges of changing how we classify hurricanes, the implications for communities, and how we might adapt to the reality of mega hurricanes. First, let's talk about the debate surrounding a potential Category 6. On one hand, many scientists and meteorologists argue that adding a new category to the Saffir-Simpson scale is necessary. A Category 6 would classify hurricanes with sustained winds of 192 miles per hour or higher, differentiating them from lower and Category 5 storms, and giving people a better sense of the heightened risk. Proponents claim this would improve public understanding of the growing threat posed by climate change-fueled hurricanes. After all, if a hurricane like Patricia or Dorian comes barreling towards a populated area, wouldn't it be better to have a term that emphasizes just how extraordinary and dangerous the storm is? But not everyone agrees. Critics point out that the Saffir-Simpson scale already has limitations. For one, it focuses solely on wind speed, ignoring other critical factors like storm surge and rainfall, which are often the deadliest aspects of a hurricane. Hurricane Harvey, for example, wasn't even a Category 5 when it made landfall, but its record-breaking rainfall caused catastrophic flooding in Texas, resulting in $125 billion in damages. adding a Category 6, some argue, could further narrow public focus on wind speed, overshadowing the broader threats posed by these storms. There's also the issue of public understanding. Would adding a new category help people grasp the severity of these storms, or would it confuse them? Some fear that introducing a Category 6 could create a false sense of security for lower-end storms, leading people to underestimate the danger of a typical Category 5 hurricane. Others worry that the jump to a new category might not significantly change evacuation behavior or preparedness efforts. After all, when faced with a storm like Patricia or Dorian, does it really matter if it's called a Category 5 or a Category 6? The destruction will be catastrophic either way. Beyond the debate over classification, the reality of stronger hurricanes has serious implications for coastal regions. These areas are already on the front lines of climate change, and the prospect of mega hurricanes only heightens the risk they face. Imagine a storm with winds exceeding 200 miles per hour, making landfall in a densely populated area. The impact would be devastating. Entire buildings would be obliterated, power grids would be destroyed, and storm surges would inundate cities, leaving millions displaced. Infrastructure that was designed to withstand hurricanes of the past may not be equipped to handle the storms of the future. And then there's the human cost. As hurricanes grow stronger, they also become more deadly. Communities in low-lying coastal areas, especially in developing countries, are at the greatest risk. These regions often lack the resources and infrastructure to prepare or to recover from such extreme events. The economic toll of mega hurricanes could be astronomical, with recovery costs stretching into the hundreds of billions of dollars. And that's not even accounting for the emotional and psychological toll on the people who survive these disasters. So what can we do to prepare for this new era of hurricanes? For starters, adaptation measures are more critical than ever. Coastal communities need to invest in stronger infrastructure, better evacuation plans, and improved warning systems. Governments and organizations must work together to ensure that vulnerable populations have the resources they need to withstand and recover from these storms. And on a global scale, addressing the root cause, climate change, remains essential. Reducing greenhouse gas emissions won't stop hurricanes, but it could help prevent the worst-case scenarios from becoming reality. Finally, we need to rethink how we measure and communicate hurricane risk. Whether or not we officially adopt a Category 6, it's clear that the Saffir-Simpson scale alone isn't enough. Scientists are exploring alternative metrics like integrated kinetic energy, which takes into account not just wind speed, but also the size and duration of a storm. This more comprehensive approach could provide a better picture of a hurricane's true destructive potential, helping communities prepare more effectively. As we wrap up, the question of whether a hurricane can surpass Category 5 isn't just a matter of if, it's a matter of when. The storms of tomorrow will test the limits of what we thought was possible, and our ability to adapt will determine how well we weather the storm. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you don't miss our next deep dive. As always, stay insanely curious.